Hi, yes, sir.
Because all your staff can be covered by your own people in your own language. So at your own convenient time in that way.
Yes, sir.
So shall we start the Secunderabad division? Secunderabad division, anybody is there? Hello? Secunderabad division? Shall we start our training session, sir? All of you?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, with your consent, we will be starting this training session. Welcome to the eOffice user training session. This one, that's when a normal user right now who are on the manual working system, when he arrives at the office, he will have the files and then receipts on his table. That is what is the everyday that we are facing. When we switched over our working onto the eOffice platform, then when he arrives at the office, he will not have any files on his table nor any receipts on his table. Everything will be available on the eOffice platform. In that backdrop, we will see now that what the employee will do from the time he stepped into the office on the eOffice platform.
So, I
request all of you kindly keep your speakers on mute, and then at the end of the session we will have the discussion forum. It will be interactive, and then I will try to attend to all your concerns. So now the session starts. So when the employee entered into the office, just switch on the computer and then you open your browser. And then it should be preferably that Internet Explorer. So our Mozilla Firefox, Internet Explorer will be a more convenient thing. And then you enter the URL there, your URL. For example, the people who are working in the South Central Railway, the URL is scr.eoffice.railnet.gov.in. The people who are on the Southern Railway, the URL is sr.eoffice.railnet.gov.in. Similarly, if some staff is there from the Western Railway, only that the first part will change, the wr.eoffice.railnet, otherwise the URL structure is the same. So enter the URL. The moment you enter the URL, you are on this screen, and then you have to give the input to login ID and then the password. Your login ID is same as your NIC email ID. Right. So your NIC email ID has been supplied to all officers and then the staff of some divisions. Other divisions also will be supplied soon. You need to add the login ID, which is the same as your NIC email ID, without the at the rate portion. Right. For example, your email ID is nagesh.kumar@gov.in. You need to enter here only the nagesh.kumar. Let us take that my NIC email ID is rameshbabu.tanniru@gmail.in. So I have entered my login ID only as the rameshbabu.tanniru. @gov.in ID should not be entered, right? At the rate portion beyond that should be removed. Remaining portion is your login ID. Is it clear? And then your password is the same as your NIC email ID password, right? Which is the same as that what is supplied to you through the Sparrow. So you enter the login ID without the @gov.in portion, and then you enter the password, which is the same as your NIC email ID, right? Some people are expecting that, sir, e-office ke liye humko password nahi aaya. So actually there is no separate password for the e-office. Whatever is the username and then password that has been given to you through the NIC email, the same thing is the credentials for the e-office platform. Only thing is that you need to enter the login ID without the @gov.in portion, and then the password is the same as your NIC email password, and then you log in. When you have logged in, this is your default screen. Right? This is your default screen. Now that on the screen that you must be seeing a lot of icons, right? A lot of details are there. So, but most of the things are not concerned to the user. The user who are there on the eOffice platform is concerned with only one item, that is the file management system. I am moving my cursor over here. That is the highlighted, that is the file management system. The entire play area of the user, entire play area of the eOffice user is only on this tab. Not other than this single tab, file management system, no other thing is concerned to him. Right? This is the only one area after logging in, he will be working. Right? So, I will try to explain you that few other things that is there on this, which may be useful to all employees. You see here, there is a toggle switch available here. I am moving my cursor over here. You see that? So, if you click on this, right, the entire web page will get transformed into a Raj Bhasha mein chale jate. So now you see that the entire web page is on the Raj Bhasha. Again, if I click on this toggle switch, then entire web page will come on to the English. So this may be very useful feature for some of the employees who are convenient to use work on the Raj Bhasha platform. So other than that, when you have logged in, you will see your name here and then your designation also. Your name and then the designation will be there. You please observe when you log in. If any discrepancies you found it, either in your name or in your designation, I request you that you please inform your admin of the division so that he will look into that. Other than this, that when the user has logged in, right, he has to go straight away into this file management system. Right? So now we clicked on that file management system. This will be the page the user is going to work on the eOffice platform. This is a single page on which the eOffice, on which the railway employee is going to work. If you observe here, on the left hand side, you are having the various tabs, the receipts, files and other one, right? So now we will see that from the each one, from the top to bottom, right? So you go to this receipts section, again you have a drop down menu. Now the next half an hour or so, we will discuss all the items that are there in this receipt section. And the first item on this receipt section is browse and diarize. Browse and diarize is the first item, right? So I click on that, right? So you are on this screen. So where this will be useful? Now in our normal day-to-day working, that we are getting the receipts, right? So either in the dispatch section or our steno, or sometimes we ourselves will get the letters either by post or by hand or whatever the medium, right? You have received a letter. Let me tell you that I have received one letter and then I have scanned it and then kept it on my desktop. This is a letter I have received by hand in my office or my steno or my dispatch section, whatever it is, right? Any of the railway employee, when he receives a letter through the dispatch or by mail or the post, the moment he receives, what he should do is that he has to scan it. For the scanning purpose, you need to use your normal scanners. You need not be having a high-end scanners, right? Normal scanners which are available on the Amazon, which can be purchased by the divisional officers within their own impressed powers, each department wise also. So I request you that you kindly procure the scanners and then make them available to your staff. It doesn't take neither much money nor much time. Right? The receipt what you have received, you have scanned it and then kept it on my desktop. Now I will see that what we will do with that. Right? So you open into the eOffice platform and then you click on this. Right? After clicking this browse and diarize tab, you have opened this screen. You kindly click on this upload file. Right? When you have clicked on this upload file and then you select that which file needs to be uploaded. Right? Right now I have shown you one file which I have scanned and then kept on my desktop. The same letter I have clicked, now that got uploaded onto the eOffice platform. And then this is the left hand side panel. On the right hand side panel, you will see that 2-3 sections are there. One is that the diary details. Diary details means these are the section which will have the details of this letter, right? What are the details it is asking? You see that only few fields are mandatory fields. Remaining things you can fill as you wish it. But the mandatory fields are must. Otherwise, this letter will not get accepted by the e-office. What are the mandatory fields you see that? One is that delivery mode. That means this letter is delivered to you how? Right? How this letter has come to you? Right? Whether it has come by hand to you, or by post, by courier, or by email, or by fax, whatever the medium through which you have received this letter, you please select it appropriately. I am selecting it that I received this letter by post. And then it is asking that which kind of document it is, right? Whether it is a letter or whether it is a meeting notice or a reminder or a report, what kind of document it is, right? So these are the details pertaining to the document, right? How you have received this document and then what kind of document it is. I am selecting this as a letter. These are the two details mandatory, and then you go down. Next one is that first portion is the diary details. The second one is the contact details. Contact details means the person who has sent this letter, who has signed this letter. So that details needs to be filled. This letter has come from the DGMG of Southwestern Railway. I am selecting this as right to Ministry of Railways. This letter is received from them, and then the departments. You have to be not programmed, just you select others, right? So need not be selecting any other thing, just you select Ministry of Railways, that is sufficient. And then the name of the sender. Name of the sender is E. Vijaya. And then her designation is DGMG. So name and designation are a must. And then the address line, I am selecting it as GM's office. GM's office, SWR. I request you to kindly keep your mic on mute mode, and then after completion of each section, we'll have a discussion session. Instead of having the discussion session at the end of this thing, after completion of each item, we will discuss the things, right? So in that way, I will be able to explain you again, right, if you have not understood. So you select this address line. I have entered it as GM's office SWR. And then there is one more category available. That is, which category of this letter? This letter belongs to which category? I am choosing this. A lot of things are available here. This letter is pertaining to e-office application. So I selected that main category as the e-office. And then the subcategory is not mandatory, and then it is not fed. And then the subject is required, right? What is the subject of this letter? Subject of this letter also, I am making it as e-office implementation. And then here you are having 2-3 options are there once, right? So you have received a letter. After receiving the letter, you have scanned it and then you have just kept it on your desktop like this, right? So you have received a letter and then you have scanned it and then kept it on your desktop, right? After that, you have opened your eOffice platform and then you are doing this browse and diarize, and then you have uploaded the file, and then you have done the three sections are there. One is that this diary details, how you have received this letter, and then what type of letter it is. And then one more section is there. This letter came from where, right? From which ministry? Ministry of Railways I have chosen. Sender name and then the designation I have fed. Address has been fed. And then one more item is there, which category, right? This letter subject is what, right? What is the major subject of this letter? And then some remarks I have given. After that you are having the three items are there here. One is called that customized acknowledgement. For example, somebody has given me this letter by hand. And then they want me that, sir, you give me an acknowledgement. They will ask or not. In our railway environment also, the people will come and then hand over the letters to us by hand. And then they will ask that, sir, please give us an acknowledgement. In that case, you click on this button, customize acknowledgement. Click on this customize acknowledgement. And then you are having the two options are there. One is that generate. Other one is that generate and send. We will see both the things one after one. First, I will take you through the generate, and then I will take you through the generate and send. what is the difference between these two also we will see, right? First I will choose the option generate and send. I click on this generate and send. You see that whatever the document I have received, now that has gone into the eOffice platform. It has gone to my servers. Now it is a part of the eOffice. When you have received a letter and then just you scanned it and then kept it on the desktop, it is not part of the eOffice. Just it was lying on your computer only. But when you have diarized that receipt, now that receipt has become a part of the eOffice platform and then it cannot be deleted by anyone. So now that I have chosen the option generate and send, now that it got generated, now I am sending it to one of the officer. And then I have chosen few letters you key in, then you will get the appropriate email address will get selected over here. You select that. I have chosen that Ashpal Tomar GM O&MSE, right? And then I am giving that remarks as the demo eOffice. Right. Don't disturb me, please. And then you are having the two buttons here. One is that the send button and other one is the send and then demo. Right? Send, e-sign and then send. Right? Options. Two I have selected. Then you are having that two options are there. Whether one is that send, other one is that e-sign and then send. If I just select a send, it will go just with my name and then designation without my signature. And then one more option is there, e-sign and then send. Then it will go into the your with the digital signature. You will get one more tab that is called that DSC sign and then send also will come. Now we will see one after one the options. Just I will click on this send and then we will see that what will be there. I just selecting that send. So and then it is also generated, right? I have pressed that button. You remember that I have chosen that customize acknowledgement. So without me doing anything, without me typing any letter, the acknowledgement letter is ready here by the eOffice itself. You see that from the details I entered to eVijaya, GM's office, SWR, acknowledgement of your letter, right? So everything got generated automatically by the eOffice platform. You need not type any acknowledgement letters or anything you need not write, right? The letter is automatically generated by the system. And then, you go to this created, right? So the receipt that what you have generated now available in this created list. Continue. Click on this continue button. Now this acknowledgement also how it is asking me that how you want to dispatch this acknowledgement. This acknowledgement you want to dispatch just like that with your name and designation, or it is asking that whether you will sign a e-sign and then send or the DSC sign and then send. E-sign and send facility is not available as per the Government of India regulations. After the Aadhaar card usage has been banned by the Supreme Court, this e-sign facility has been withdrawn. Now we are having only two options. That is, the one is the send option. That means it will go just by your name and designation. One more option is that DSC sign and then send. I will choose the option DSC sign and then send. And then it is also asking that how you want to dispatch this acknowledgement to the sender. Whether you want to send it by mail or you send it by post. I will choose the option send it by mail and then I will enter the email ID. And then it is also asking that you want to send the notification through the SMS. I will also select that. You please understand this process, right? Somebody has handed over the document to you by hand or it has come to you by post, right? This all comes under the public services, right? So somebody, some document you have received, what the other party expects is that we want to get an acknowledgement or some kind of a notification that you have received this letter. So this is how that the moment you have scanned the letter and then diarized it, Now the moment you generate an acknowledgement, it is asking that acknowledgement can be sent by mail and then notification can be given by SMS also. After doing this, if I just click on this send button, now that acknowledgement has gone to the sender through his mail as well as through his SMS notification to his mobile number also. This is how that you can send the acknowledgement to the pupil who has given you the documents, either by post or mail or fax or by hand or any of the mediums. Now you see that here, acknowledgement has been sent. The sent acknowledgement is available in the sent folder, right? You see that there is a tab available acknowledgement. Within that acknowledgement, you are having the two sub tabs created and then sent. You just click on this sent, you are having this acknowledgement that has been sent. You click on that, you see that this is the acknowledgement which has been sent just now, right? So the acknowledgement has gone to the sender, right? The user received the acknowledgement, same time that is available in your sent box also. But so far we are only looking at the acknowledgement, we have not looked at that what happened to the document itself, right? The document, right? So two parts are there. One is that acknowledgement part. Second one is that the document itself, right? The document is available in this created part, right? The document has been available, sent. You see here in the sent folder, the letter what you have sent is available, right? So this is the letter I have sent at 10:29 a.m., right? With the timestamp, date, right? To whom you have sent, everything will be available, right? The document number and all. Here one facility is available on the eOffice platform. For example, instead of sending to some Vijay, I have sent to Ashpal Singh Tomar sir. Now that what I can do? Normal case, for example, you have sent the document by post or something, you cannot do anything, right? You have wrongly posted to A person instead of sending to B person, then you cannot do anything, you cannot recall it back. Whereas on the eOffice platform, just now you have seen that I have sent a document to some person and then after sending it, I realized that arre bhai, main galti mein A aadmi ko bhej diya instead of sending to B person. I can do one thing. Just you see that at the end of this communication, you are having one symbol available. That is, if you put the mouse over there, you will get that pullback option. You click on that, you will get pullback option. You just to give the remarks why you want to pull back the document. You need to give a remarks that why you want to pull back the document, right? So it is not that you can send the document to someone and then again you pull back, again you send, again pull back. You cannot do like that. You need to give a remarks whenever you are doing any extra normal activities. So I am giving the remarks that sent by mistake. Sent by mistake. And then I click OK. Now you see that this document has been withdrawn from the A person, but the withdrawn letter is available in my inbox again. Right? So I have scanned one letter, diarized it, and then I want to send this letter to Mr. B, but instead of sending to B, my letter went to A. And then from A, you have seen that I have withdrawn the letter. I have pulled back the letter, and then it is available in my inbox. Now I will click on this document. Now I will send to one more sender, right? To the right person I will send. I will send this document to the right person this time. I am sending this letter to the self itself. You see that the document has gone to the right person now. So with this, we have completed one activity that is called the browse and direct. I request to all of you, right, if you have any doubts on this, you can please ask. Is it clear that
I have one question.
Yes, please.
When we are sending acknowledgement.
Yeah.
You have to give email ID and the mobile number.
That is optional, ID. Sir. That is optional, sir. That means it is asking how you want to send the document.
If I want to send by email, whose email ID I have to give?
To that person, sir. That person, that to whom you want to send it, if you know his email address,
okay,
you can enter the email ID.
If
you know his mobile number, you give his mobile number, so that he will receive this acknowledgement through the email to him, as well as he will receive a notification on his mobile.
Okay.
If you don't know either of the thing, neither the mobile number nor the email ID, you have left with only one option, send by post.
Okay.
You select it, send by post, then you do the normal course, you take a printout and then you send it by post.
Okay, can we send a semicolon and send two persons at the same place?
Sir, letter can be sent to more than one person, to any number of people, but the two address, just I will show you, sir, just now. I have selected this diary and then I am sending it. I have chosen this send button. Here two option is there, no sir? The two can be addressed to only one person.
Okay.
And then you see that in the CC button, copy, right? To copy, you can mark to any number of people.
But two address can be only one.
Normally the original letter will be only one author, no? See.
No, very rarely it is also for two to three persons also.
Two address is limited to one person. So remaining all will be in the CC, you can send it. So there is no limit for the number of people to whom you can send it.
Okay.
So any other doubts regarding this? Regarding this browse and diarize is concerned. Anyone? Secunderabad, Nanded, Trichy, Hyderabad.
Secunderabad?
Yeah, please.
No doubts, sir.
No doubts. Oh, good, great. Yes, please.
Sir, from Nanded, sir.
Yeah,
morning, sir.
Please.
Sir, the generate portion you are not explained, sir. You are going to explain now, sir. You have explained.
I have explained to you straight away that generate and send.
And send, yes, sir.
I will show you the generate also. It is a simple
fine,
one.
Sir, fine.
So
fine,
up to here there is no doubts, no?
No doubt, sir. It's fine, sir.
Okay, that's great. So now we will see that again. I am going to the same document. I will show you a very important feature. One thing available here. I have received one letter from someone. And then the document I have opened, that means this is a old letter. Old letter that is available in my inbox. I have received this letter from person A. I have received and then diarized. Here there is one button available, copy. You remember, you see that? Copy. You click on this copy. Right? So when you click on this copy, normally we understand that when you click on the copy, the document gets copied. No, it is not that. Right? This diary details will get copied. Right, the diary details, right? Yesterday I received a letter from Mr. A and then I have diarized it. And then today also I received one more letter from the Mr. A. So I need not enter all the details of the Mr. A again in the diary details. Right, I will go to the yesterday's letter which was sent by Mr. A. Right, this is a letter sent by Mr. A yesterday to me, or yesterday or day before yesterday or sometime back. Right, and then today I received again one more letter from Mr. A. So normal procedure, you have seen that whenever you receive a letter, you scan it and then upload it. After that, you need to enter the entire diary details. Now that when I receive today a letter from Mr. A, I need not enter all the details, diary details of the Mr. A. I need to do that. I will do simply a shortcut available. I will go to the sent box and then I will select the letter which is received from Mr. A sometime back. Right? In the sent folder, a lot of things will be available to me. I just click on that. And then I just click on this copy button. Right? Now all the diary details of Mr. A got automatically copied on this right hand side panel. Right? And then I will upload the letter which I received today from him. That's it. Right? Today I received this letter from him. And then diary details, what was there, that got automatically filled. Now I can edit certain things if I want to edit it, right? Maybe that delivery mode may be the same, the type may be the same, sender name I need not type again, designation I need not type, ministry I need not type, address I need not type, and then I can choose the letter type may be different. I can choose that, right, which kind of the letter it is. I will choose one more, eOffice, demo and training, right. Like that I will choose, and then I will click on this. Is it clear that how to use the copy button, copy feature? Copy feature is very useful to you, right. You have received some document daily, very frequently you are receiving a document, some person, Mr. X. And then the letters which you have replied to Mr. X is available in your sent box. Right? Just you go to the sent box and then you select that and then you copy. Just you click on the copy on the top, then entire diary details will get copied. You need not type all those things. Right? Once you have done that activity, now this is the second letter I am demonstrating to you. Right? The second letter I received. I can diarize as it is what I explained in the earlier session, or I can copy the document details and then I can proceed. Now I am clicking on this generate button. Right? Earlier we have seen that generate and send. Now just I am clicking on this generate button. You see that now this second letter has also got generated. So this generated letter, where it will be there? Anyone can tell? This generated letter, right? This generated letter will be there on this created folder. Just to click on this created, then this is the letter just now I generated. You see that created on 14/5/2019, 10:43 hours. Just now I created, this is available here, right? So when you have earlier selected generate and send, directly it went to the user, right? Directly it went to the user. Now just you click on this generate only, then it will get generated but not sent to the user. It will be available in your created folder. Now that I can choose it, at my convenient time, I can dispatch to the person. Right? I have received, where you will use this generate and then generate send. You have received a letter and then you are very clear that to whom it should be sent. Then directly you select the generate and send, and then you add the sender email ID and then it will go. Or you have received a letter and then you don't know that to whom the reply is to be given. In that case, you scan it, diarize it and then generate. Right? Then it will be available in your created list. Right? And then at your convenient time, you open that and then you can send it. So, this is how that you can send that. And then send. You see that earlier in your created folder, there used to be one letter available. Now it is not there. So from the created, I have sent it. Where it will be available in my this thing, you see that I am having one sent folder. Whatever the letters that I have dispatched, all the things will be available in my sent folder. Right? So, you are having all kinds of details, right? What is the receipt number, which is generated automatically by the system, and then the subject, sender, sent to whom. Here you will observe one very important feature, right? So, normally that when you have sent a letter to 5 people, what you will do? You will send a person with one covering letter. That person will take that letter 5 Xerox copies. And then go to the 5 people offices and then hand over to them, and then he will take the acknowledgement from each one. Now, for example, for the sake of explanation, just now I have marked this letter to 2 people. To how many number of people you send it, that many number of people will get reflected in this sent box. That means each individual, if you send to the 10 people, all the 10 people will get reflected in this sent folder. Sent to whom? Right? And then what time? And then you can pull back from the each individual. Right? For example, you have sent the letter to 10 people, then you are having that 10 entries on the sent folder, right? You see here right now that E22, the folder that I have generated just now, I have marked to 2 people, 2 entries are available. And then if I realize that, or if I, out of the 10 people, one person I have sent it by mistake, then I can pull back from that single person also. Remaining 9 people will remain undisturbed. So like that, you will use this browse and diarize function. Any doubts are there on this? One is that customize acknowledgement, another one is generate, and other one is that generate and send. Any doubts, please, so that we will proceed to the next item. Hyderabad division. Is there any doubts we can see that now here?
Yeah, you can speak. Please hold on.
Yeah, please.
Okay, there is a doubt. How much time is allowed for pullback?
Pullback, as long as the other person has not opened the document, you can pull back. There are no time limits.
Okay.
Once the other person opens the document and then he reads the document, then there is no point in pulling back because already it is delivered to him.
Good.
Then you will not get that symbol at the end of the document. Okay.
That's right.
Any other doubts, please?
Your kind of doubt from there? One doubt is that we can suggest to keep two numbers or three numbers more than one person in the email. Because it is so happened, sometimes one or two branch officers we have to communicate at the same time, and copy is for information only.
Okay. But as per this customization, sir, that the 2 is to one person and then the copy will go to the remaining people. So there are no other customizations possible in this package.
Sir, Vijayawada.
Yes, please.
Sir, till such time the regular scanners are arranged. Can we use our cell phones or cam scanner, sir?
Yes, you can use anything.
Okay, sir.
You can use anything.
So this pullback arrangement is, once they have opened it, is not possible further.
Naturally, that when you have already delivered to the other person and then other person has read the letter, there is no meaning in the pulling back.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
I request that to all the people joining through the VC to be please interactive as much as possible. If you are having any doubts, you please ask at the end of the each topic, right? At the end of the each topic, we will discuss it for 5-10 minutes. You please ask any of the doubts are there so that we will be here to solve your problems. So, shall we proceed to the next item?
Ramesh, one question from this side.
Yes, Ramesh, please.
One question is, suppose I have sent one letter to n number of people, sir.
Okay.
In this ko bhej diya, in ko bhej diya, in ko bhej diya. So, okay. Yes.
Just now you see that in the sent folder, I have sent this letter to 2 people, E22. Main do aadmi ko bhej diya, do separate entries are available here.
Nee,
10 people, 10 separate entries are there.
Recipient. Ye to mera eOffice platform hai na.
Okay.
Suppose maine kisko bheja.
Theek hai.
उसको पता पड़ेगा कि ये कॉपी कितनों को हुई है
तो उनको ना मालूम नहीं होता है उनको मालूम नहीं होता है This is not like a Gmail that you will see all the contacts.
This is how will the person come to know this is actionable required from my end or mere jaise information ke liye mila. How will that get differentiated?
No, that you will see that whether it is marked a CC to you or this thing when you open it, you will be able to identify it.
Okay, theek.
Yes, please.
Sir, suppose मैंने दो आदमी को भेज दिया, फिर बाद में मुझे याद आया कि एक आदमी को और भेजना है, उस समय उसको कैसे रिट्रीव करके भेजेंगे?
या नो नीड टू रिकॉल. सी, यू नीड टू सेंड टू तीन आदमी को भेजने के लिए, दो आदमी को भेजा आप. नाउ यू वांट टू सेंड टू द थर्ड पर्सन, राइट?
राइट सर.
यू गो टू योर सेंट बॉक्स, राइट? And then now that E22 letter just now I have generated, and then I sent to two people. Okay? That two are available. Now click on that same document. It opened. Okay? Now you send the same document to the third person.
Okay. Thank you, sir.
Yeah. So in that way, you can send to any number of people. Just from your sent folder, you select it and then you send it again. Okay?
Thank you, sir.
Yeah. Any other doubts regarding this browse and diarize is concerned?
Sir?
Yes, please.
Sir, the third person, if he should be marked CC, he should not be marked in a 2.
There are no technical difference here, that because normally that in your normal way of living, original can be only one. Remaining all that you take a Xerox, so people will be able to see the difference whether it is original or Xerox. Whereas in this particular case, everything is scanned, everybody will get the same document. So there is no difference between the whether you have addressed to 22 or whether you have addressed to CC. Right? So there is no difference actually. So everybody will get the same copy. You have marked the person to 2 also will get the same thing. You have marked to the CC also will get the same thing.
Okay,
it is only some technical, I don't know that exactly that how the NIC has conceived it, but there are no difference as far as the end user is concerned of what document he receives.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
Any other doubt, please? Shall we proceed?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now we will go to this. Browse and diarize is an item that any document you receive at your office, whether it is 1-page letter or 5-page letter or 100-page letter, right, a document, your job is that you scan it, then keep it on your desktop or in some folder, and then you log into your eOffice platform, and then you go to this browse and diarize, you click on this, and then you click on this upload file, okay? Click on upload file, you select that file, whether it is single page or 5 pages or 100 pages. You click on that, select that, and then enter the details of that document. And then you are having the three options. If you want to give an acknowledgement to the sender, you choose this customized acknowledgement and then give an acknowledgement to the sender. For example, you have received a letter from the RDSO, some circular. You need not give an acknowledgement to the RDSO that I have received this letter. So, right? So in that case, you need not choose this customized acknowledgement. You just either the generate and send, or you generate it. Right? Or some private individual has given you a letter, or some other offices, some letter has come where you need to give an acknowledgement, then you please choose this customized acknowledgement so that the sender will get the acknowledgement. Okay? So this is how that the browse and diarize part will be done. Here one important item that I would like to tell you, that what kind of documents you can upload, right? You see here, upload only PDF up to 20 MB, right? So the documents which you can upload on the eOffice platform is only up to the 20 MB, right? More than that, you cannot upload through the receipt section. But there are the other ways are there, I will be able to show you in the subsequent stages. Right? So, for example, you have received some 2-page letter. Naturally, it will be less than some 1 MB or 500 KB or something. Within the 20 MB, roughly around 100 pages can be scanned. Right? Roughly around 100 pages to 150 pages will come within this 20 MB capacity. In the normal course of time, you will never receive, you will not receive very often the documents or receipts which are having 100 pages, 200 pages, 500 pages. So 99.9% of the documents you receive will be less than the 20 MB capacity. Now we will see that you have received a document which is having 500 pages. Now what to do? Now the capacity is more than 20 MB. So in that case, I request you that you kindly divide that document into the two portions or three portions or five portions, and then accordingly you upload it, right? The part 1, part 2, part 3, right? Where you will write part 1, part 2, part 3? You will write here in the subject portion, right? RDSO document, right? RDSO LED bulbs document part 1. RDSO LED bulbs document part 2. RDSO LED bulbs document part 3. Like that, you will be able to make it. Ahmedabad, please mute your section. Somebody joining from Ahmedabad. A single person. Okay. So, when you received a document which is having large number of pages, let us say that 500 pages or 1000 pages, in that case, I request you that you divide that document into the two portions or five portions or 10 portions, and then you will be able to diarize them through naming it as the document name, and then part 1, part 2, part 3, part 4, like that. You can upload that documents onto the eOffice platform. That is one way. But there are large other ways are there. That also we will see. There you need not split the document. There is no need for that. There are the other ways are there. I will be able to explain to you in the subsequent steps. Okay? So, I think we have completed this browse and diarize portion in all respects, including the capacity, right? Only the PDF documents, right, which is having the capacity less than 20 MB can be browsed and diarized. Now, come to the next tab, that is the inbox. This is the play area for the user, the moment when he come to the office. When he come to the office, when he open the computer, and then when he log in, what he has to see, first item is that this inbox. In the inbox, if any receipts has been sent to you, any letters are marked to you, everything will get reflected on this inbox. Right? This is the receipts inbox, and then below the receipts, you see that there is one more section there, files. In that also, files inbox also will be there. If you have received any files, your DRM has marked you some files, your boss has marked you some files, or your subordinate has sent you some files, all those files will be available on this inbox. Right? What you could have had otherwise on your table are now available in the inbox. Same is the case with the receipts. Right? Your DRM has marked you some 3-4 letters to you. Earlier it used to come to you on your table. Now it will be available on the inbox. Now let me see that I have come to office, and then on the eOffice platform I have been rolled in. And then I logged in my computer, and then I have gone to my inbox. You see that now in my inbox I am having two letters. Now let us see that what I will do with these two letters. The same is the thing that every employee will do at their end. So I click on this one letter, right? So when I click on this letter, you see that at the top of that, right, the letter gets opened, and then you are also getting the receipt details. That means that who has sent this letter, when they have sent it, right? So all those details also get displayed. Now I need to decide that what action I need to do it on that letter. I have options. You see that lot many options are there. One is that send, one is that send back, one more is that put in a file, the other one is the copy. We have seen that what is the function of this copy, right? The copy has nothing to do with copying this document. The copy has altogether a different purpose that we have seen that. And then you are having one more option called the dispatch details like this. We will see one after one what are the things that we can do with this document. I will choose this, right? I have received one letter, and then I want to send this. I have received this letter from, let us say that some AST has put up a letter to the senior DST. Now, on the senior DST inbox, this letter is available. Now the senior DST will send it to the DRM. Let us say that this is the leave letter of the AST for 1 year. Right? So senior DST obviously cannot sanction that. So he need to forward it to the DRM or someone. In that case, now we'll see that he received a letter on his inbox. Now he is select the send button, and then he will select that other end person to whom he want to send. I am using two accounts for the training purpose, right? So here itself I will be able to send from one account to the other account, and then I will show you that how these documents will be reflected in the other's account. I have selected this document I am sending to Mr. Ashpal Singh Tomar, and then I have given the remarks for approval, please. Let us say that this Ashpal Singh Tomar sir is some DRM, I am a branch officer, and then I am sending this, right? The letter is received from AHT, I am sending to the DRM, right? So I have entered the remarks, and then I have clicked on this send button. You see that earlier in my inbox two letters are there, now only one letter is there, because the one letter what I have dispatched to him. Now I have gone to the this Ashpal Singh Tomar sir account, I have opened it. You see that in his inbox, there is a letter available. See, just now I have sent him the letter, 11:03, right? At 11:03, I have sent this letter to him. It is available in his inbox, right? This will show you the enormous benefits and advantages that are inbuilt on the eOffice platform, right? Everything gets recorded. Everything can be traced. No time waste. At the same time, your workload on the every employee will come down drastically, right? They will get freed mentally as well as physically from their workloads on the eOffice platform. Lot many facilities has been built on the eOffice platform to encourage the employees to have more a personal time, right? So I request that to all the employees to please observe this process, right? So just now I have sent the letter to the next Ashpal Singh Somar sir, and then it is available in his inbox. And then he will open that document. Now that he read this document, right? Somebody has asked him that 1 year leave, right? Now he sir can decide two things, whether he can send it to that fellow with approval, or he can send it back. For example, it is within his powers, he will sanction it. If it is not in his powers, he may forward it to the CST, right? So like this, when you open a document, you will use this send button, right? Open a document, and then to whomever you want to send, you click on this send, and then click on this send, and then you select the address, you give the remarks, and then you send it back. Simple, that is. Okay? Now we will see what are the other options available. Same letter I am taking it, right? So DRM sir has opened the letter, and then he read that 1 year leave, and then he don't want to sanction. He can select just simply the sent back option, right? He click on this sent back, right? Then this letter will go back to the person who has sent him. Just to click on this sent back, then the address you need not enter, right? From where this letter has come, to whom it will go back, and then he will write that not approved. Not approved due to urgent scheduled works. And then he will click on the send button. Now from his inbox, it has gone back to the original sender. We will see that whether it has reflected on the original sender's inbox. You see that whatever the letter has been sent by him, again came back onto the eOffice platform at 11:06. So this is how that every action will be very fast. With minimum effort, maximum output you can produce on the eOffice platform. So this is how that inbox. So we have seen that two things. One is that sent, and the other one is the sent back option. Now that this letter has come to you, and then you feel that it is some kind of an RDS for circular, right? Neither you need not send back, nor you send to somebody else. What you need to do, just you read it, and then you will close it, right? So you see that there is one button available, close, right? So you just select that close option. It is asking the remarks, right? When you want to close any document, then you need to furnish a remarks. You are not either sending to someone, nor you are sending it back, nor you are putting it into some file. You are simply received a document and then you are closing it, right? That should be a very conscious effort, right? Somebody has asked you some leave letter, has come to you, instead of either approving or disapproving, you simply close it, then it is a serious issue. So whenever you are closing a document, you need to furnish a remarks, why you want to close it. Now I am giving the remarks that work done. And then I clicked on this, okay. You see that earlier in the inbox, two letters are there, one has gone. Where it has gone? That also available here. You see here, you are having one item called that closed, right? There is a tab closed, right? And then by me, you click on that. This is the letter. Just now I have closed it, 11 hours, 7 minutes. That is available in the closed folder. When you have closed a receipt or when you have closed a file, it doesn't mean that a file aisa hai gayab hota hai. Aisa nahi hota hai, right? So, no, nothing, not a single paper on the eOffice platform can be deleted or can be modified by anyone at any point of time, right? You have completed reading the receipt, you can close it at the most, but you cannot delete it, right? This is how that a document can be closed. Now, we'll see that what are the other options available, right? You have seen send, you have seen the sent back, you have seen the copy. You have seen the close. Now we will see one more item called that put in a file, right? You
have, I have a question.
Yes,
I have a question regarding closing of the document.
Yes, yes, please.
Like I have sent a proposal to my DRM.
Okay.
And he has closed it.
Okay.
So how will I know the status of my proposal?
You will not be able to know it because the person who has closed has done a conscious effort by giving his remarks. Right, so only, but the file tracking will be there, the receipt tracking will be there, it will be available at his end.
Okay.
You want but to I know that where know, the proposal
I will not
is.
The, no, I will not know the fate of my file.
The fate is that it is available with the DRM, simple.
Okay.
You have sent to him, right, it is available with him, it has not come back from him. So, it is available with him. You will be able to trace it completely that where it was sent last, or how long it was lying with whom. Any other doubts up to now? Sir, regarding original, the send back?
Sir, original sender is AST.
Okay.
And close kiya sir, usko DRM suppose.
Theek hai.
तो ओरिजिनल जो सेंडर है उसको क्या व्यू होगा कि ये क्लोज हो गया है या व्यू नहीं होगा उसको
नहीं यू विल नॉट बी एबल टू नो दैट सी आई हैव रिसीव्ड अ लेटर राइट ये मेरा राइट है सी अ लेटर हैज बीन रिसीव्ड इन माय ऑफिस राइट सो नाउ दैट वेदर आई कैन टीयर इट डाउन एंड देन पुट इनटू अ डस्टबिन आर आई कैन कीप इट इन सम फाइल आर जस्ट आई विल लीव इट ऑन माय टेबल नाउ इन द मैनुअल वर्किंग आल्सो यू आर डूइंग द सेम थिंग नो There are no one who can stop you from doing these things.
But AST is also the same thing. Know that, sir, that whether the file is closed. AST actually could not know that whether the file is closed or it is further processed anywhere.
It is, he will be able to know that the file is available with the DRM. That much he knows it.
Okay.
It is available with him. From him it goes anywhere, again you will be able to know it. But where it is, it will be known. So, the last receiver, this is like a letter, right? So, the letter has been sent to you. This is not a file. This is only a letter. Letter has been received by me. I will read it and then I will close it. Or I will send it back. Or I will send to somebody else.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
Right? So, and then you see that there is one more button available called the movements. You click on this movements. You will know the complete trail of this file, folder, this receipt. This receipt, you see that this receipt was originated at 10:29 a.m. by some Ramesh Babu, right? And then it was sent to Mr. Ashpal Singh Tomar at 10:35. And then again it was returned back to him at 10:36, right? Now the file is available with Mr. Ramesh Babu, right? You see that this complete portion. right? Since the birth of this receipt, right? This receipt must have been originated some 5 years back also. From the last 5 years, that from where to where this receipt has gone, when, everything will be known. And then the currently where it is, that will be told. Right? So this is the tab that is called the movements. Right? And then you are also having one more item called the details. Right? If you click on this details, then you will know the history associated with this receipt. Right? So whether dispatch history, right, any files that has been attached earlier with this or detached with this receipt. So entire thing will be known to you, right? The entire history of this file will be known to you if I click on this details. And the movements, you will only know that from where to where it has went. But in the details portion, you will know still further minute details. Along with this document, any file I have sent to you, bhejte na? Bhejte nahi bhejte bhai? See, the DRM asks that a letter has come from the GM, and then the DRM will mark to the senior DPO and then ask him that you put up along with one file, connected file. Am bhejte nahi bhejte DRM sahab ko, a letter ke saath ek file.
Bhejte
sir. Like that situations, you will know everything here. Along with this letter, ask him to keep it in silent mode, please. Along with this letter, any files has been attached earlier, any files has been detached, any other letters has been attached. So all those things, history will be known through this details tab. And then one more item is available, the dispatch. Now this letter is available in my inbox, right? Either I can send it through the eOffice platform to someone, or I can send back to someone, right? The same person who has sent me the receipt. Or I can choose that I have received a letter, right? So senior DR coordination has put up a letter to the DRM, right? Which is concerned to the municipal corporation of that town, right? Or Ministry of Civil Aviation, some concerned item. Now the DRM sir has received this letter. Now that he cannot dispatch this letter to that municipal corporation because they are not there on the e-office platform. In that case, he has to choose. Send is no use for him because they are not on the e-office platform. Send back is not a correct option. The only option left over for him to take it forward is that he has to click on this dispatch section. When he click on this dispatch section, then you will have the options that how you want to dispatch this letter. Right? So you want to dispatch it by hand or by post, whatever all the things. So we'll see in detail the dispatch section at a later time. But this is another feature called the dispatch. Sir. Now we will go back to this put in file, which is very important letter, right? So this item is very important and then we use it very often, right? This is the same letter you think that it is received from some RDSO circular. You read that circular and then you will not just leave it. You will not just close it. You want to keep it in the RDSO circular file, right or wrong? We are doing it no right now. Or this letter is some passenger complaint letter. We receive it, we read it, and then we just need not throw it out, right? We will keep it in a file and then maybe put up to the appropriate authorities. So in that case, this letter I have received, I am putting in a file, right? This putting in a file process, you please observe it carefully, right? So this letter I am putting into a file, right? So when you click on this, put in a file, then you see that right hand side one panel got opened. In that there is one button available called the create file. I click on this create file. This is a non significant. Pardon? Railtel people are great in that sense. Moses, you tell them that the empty rooms to be get disconnected at least. They are causing harassment. So you go to this create file and then you click on this non-SFS, right? There is only one option. Earlier there used to be SFS and the non-SFS. SFS means...
Fiscal file ID.
So physical file. So you click on this non-SFS section, then you are opened with this tab. See here, this is the file template, right? Anytime you want to create a new files, you will get this kind of a template. This is similar to your manual files, right? The manual files that you are having is also must be having similar kind of a structure, right? So now you want to open a new file. I am selecting, right? The primary unit I am selecting, right? I need not write anything, right? So all the admins know that the process they have done, right? There is a one file naming system is there through which they have programmed your files. The moment you just you keep your cursor here, then you will get a drop down menu. This will be your respective railways, right? So you belong to the Southern Railway, your drop down menu automatically Southern Railway will come. If you belong to Northern Railway, automatically there is only one option will come, Northern Railway. Just you click on that, right? Nothing more you need to do. Just you put on a cursor there on the first part, you will get your railway in the drop down menu. You select it. For the railtel people, it will come RCIL. For the CTIs, it will come as a CTI. Or some production unit is there, that production unit name will come. Then you keep it onto the second portion. Here that all your divisions will come, right? So all your divisions will come, right? So whichever the division you belong to, that also will get customized to you. That particular one only will be there. You just you select on that. And then the third one will be your department, right? So the department to which you belong to, that also if your administrator has correctly mapped it and then given you the roles, only your department will come from the drop-down menu. You need not even select anything. Just to only one option will be there. You select that. And then the fourth one will be the various sections that are available in your department. For example, I belong to an engineering department and then I am working, I am a chief OS of the establishment section. So what I will do, I will log in and then the moment, right, I am a chief OS establishment of the Southern Railway headquarters engineering department. Let me say that. If that is the example, when I logged in, and then when I am opening a new file, when the moment I put my cursor over here on the first part, here on the drop down menu, only the Southern Railway will come. I selected that. The second one, I kept my mouse over here. It will come the zonal headquarters. Simply I select that. The third portion, when I click the mouse over here, that engineering department will come. Just I select that. The fourth one is that, so whatever the file sections within that engineering department, lot of sections are there. Establishment section, AMC section, tender section, right? Some DAR section, procurement section, like that they are having some 41 sections are there. Similarly that each department will have some sections. All those sections will come over the drop down menu. You please select the concerned section which belongs to you. If your administrator has programmed you perfectly, then you will not get anything else other than your own section, right? So you select that section to which you belong to, and then the next portion you see the empty space here, that the file name will get generated automatically by the eOffice. You need not do anything with it. The file number will get generated and then allotted by the eOffice. The next one is the year of creation, that is also by default appears that this file is being generated in 2019. And then, the last section is there, that is called that, you remember that all admins know that you people have programmed the file groups, right? File code you have created. That file codes will get reflected over here. This is nothing but to which organizational unit you belongs to. That means like which office you belongs to, right? So why that is required here? These things are required to identify that this file belongs to the Southern Railway, this file belongs to the Southern Railway Zonal Headquarters, this file belongs to the Southern Railway Zonal Headquarters Engineering Department, this file belongs to the Southern Railway Zonal Headquarters Engineering Department and then Establishment Section. Up to that, these four tabs will tell. And then the file number gets generated and then this one, this 2019 will get generated. But this last portion is there, no? This last portion will be automatically will come to you, that the last portion signifies that, okay, this is the description of the file, Right? Whereas this last portion is that this file belongs to which office? This file belongs to the office of the DRM or office of the senior DSTE or office of the ASTE or the office of the AEN or the office of some SSE signal traction. To which office it belongs to? This file belongs to which office will be known to you through this last section, right? That code also will come to you automatically. There is nothing that you need to do. Normally, when you are opening the file, you need to write a lot of English, right? You will write that code, year, etc., etc., your office name and all. In the eOffice platform, you need not do anything. Everything will be appearing on the drop-down menus. You select it. And then there is one item called the description. Here where that the actual the description of the file goes into, right? So I am writing here that railway SME plans. I write the description of the file here. You people also will write your own description. Here, this is a very important part. This description part is very important. So right now that you people are working in the railway environment, you must be having some system of the file naming, right? So for example, some engineering department, I think they will name it as works slash some 104, like that. They are having some unique number. Similarly, the personnel department, or every department must be having their own numbering system and then describing the files. To not to disturb the existing system and then to have a seamless merger from the existing system to the eOffice platform, I request you people that you please enter your existing nomenclature and then the file names, whatever the procedure that you are following in this description portion. In addition to that, some elaborate portions that we write on the file, right? So all those things, we enter it into this description portion. And then there is one more item available that is called the category. You see that there is one file available category, right? So you people, all administrators knows that they have worked on the file management system mainly on the two heads. One is that the file heads, one other one is the subject master. In that, they have created one subject category and they also created one subject subcategory. So the subject category and then subject subcategory, what you have created will appear here. If you have not created anything, nothing will appear here. So I request that all departments, all divisions, please take care of that. If you want that some particular file to be categorized clearly, that to which category they belongs to, you please feed that data in that file naming system in the subject master tag, right? To create all the subjects, sub-subjects available in your division department wise, so that when the user creating the file, he will get all the data through the drop down menus. I am selecting the subject as eOffice and then I am selecting this one as a demo. After this, just you click on this continue working, you will get one confirmation dialog box. Receipt, whatever the receipt is there, you remember that where we have started all these things. We have started with a receipt. Receipt I have started and then I have clicked on this put in a file. When you want to put in a file, either you should have a existing file or you are creating a new file. I have created a new file. After this new file, entire description is given. It is giving one alert message. Receipt is inserted in the newly created file. You click on this OK. You see that earlier one letter used to be there in my receipts inbox. Now it is not there. So where it has gone? Anyone guess?
File.
It has gone into the file. Let us check that whether it has gone into the file or not. You go to this one completed file, right? Within that file, inbox created, and then within the created, completed. Click on this completed. Within this file, you see that this is the file that you have created just now. Okay?
This is the file I have created at 14/5/2019, 11:25 hours, just now. I click on this file. You see that the file number, everything gets automatically generated by the system. This is the first file for your information I generated on the eOffice platform. Hence, the file number has come as 1. Right? And then you see that this is a letter I have kept it in the file. Right or wrong? This is the letter. Right? I have kept it on the file. Right? The letter was there. I have selected that. Put in a file. Now this letter has gone into the file. So now that you need to see what further actions you will do with this file. So we will continue this when we deal with the file section. We will go back to the receipt section and then we will have a continuity of that. We have seen the sent option, we have seen the sent back option, we have seen that put in a file, when a letter is received, how you will send to someone, how you send back to the original sender, how you can put into a file, this also we have seen. And then we know that how to use this copy button. And then the dispatch we will see in detail at some point of time in this session. And then the details, if you click on this details, then the entire history of the receipt, right? So what are the documents which has been attached to it, any files has been moved along with this receipt, etc. will be known. And then there is one more item is available called the movements. By clicking on these movements, you will know the complete history since its creation of this receipt, who has created this receipt, from whom to whom it went, and then right now that this receipt is with whom, everything will be known to you. And then there is one option available called edit. I click on this edit. So through edit, what do you think that I can edit? Anyone guess? I have clicked on this edit button. This has appeared. Can you please tell me that to anyone that what I can edit? Okay. So the document cannot be edited because it is in the PDF form. So only thing you can edit is this details, right? So this diarized details, this metadata details. For example, your PA has received a letter. He has scanned and then diarized and then he has sent it to you. You have opened the document. You have read that. And then in this metadata, you observe that instead of typing Mr. Vijay, E. Vijay, your PA has typed it as a Vijaya. You have observed that mistake, you can just to correct it and then you can save the receipt, right? This is the purpose of this edit button, right? Through this edit, you can edit this metadata, right? But this edit option can be done only by the one level after the original receipt is generated. For example, your PA has generated this receipt and then sent to some senior DPO. And then senior DPO, while reading the letter, if you observe, he can edit the metadata. But the senior DPO has sent this to the DRM and the next level, so they cannot edit it, right? So this edit can be done by the original creator or one level after that. So this is the purpose of this edit button. And then close, we have seen that. You have received a letter and then you, after reading that, if you feel that the job is done, you want to close it. Somebody has asked many doubts. I have sent a proposal to DRM, sir, if you close it, what to do? The DRM will never close it like that. Don't worry about it. But you are having a lot of situations where you need to close the document, right? So you have received some letter, which is just an information sake.
You will just read it and then you close it, right? You have no other business to do. It is maybe not worth even to keep in a file. It is not worth to send, etc., etc. Just to, you receive lot of letters every day in the DAC for all of you. You will just read it and then leave it. So such type of the letters, instead of keeping it in your inbox, I request you that after reading it, you just choose the option close so that it will get closed. Right? And then you can trace that your closed history through the closed by me. After that, you are having one more button called the view draft. Right? So along with this letter, the sender has sent you some draft messages that will get displayed over here. Right? The sender not only sent the document to you, right? Your PA has received one letter. He has scanned it and sent it to the senior DPO. Along with that letter, your PA also created a draft for you. Sir, the reply for this letter is put up here. And then he will prepare a reply and then he will attach it as a draft and then send it to you. For you, the job becomes very easy. We will see that situation, how the draft is to be prepared and then sent to higher authorities or the lower one, right? But that is how that you will see this draft. If you click on this view draft, if any drafts are attached with this letter, you will be able to see it. Right? And then there is one more facility available that is called the attach file and then detach file. Right? So your DRM has received a letter from the municipal commissioner and then regarding some item. And then the DRM has marked it to the Synodian coordination and asked him that you please send that consent connected file also to me. Then in that case, what the Synodian coordination will do, he will receive this letter along with the remarks, he will attach the file and then send it back to the DRM. You see that attach file. Right? Along with this receipt, I want to attach this file and then send it, right? This browser, right? This is how that you can attach the files to the receipts. Log out. There is no other option. Sometimes the software may behave a little erratic, but I tell all of you that please have a trust on this platform. This eOffice platform has been developed by the NIC and then which is a time-tested platform, right? So it may be new to the Indian Railways, but it has been in working for more than a decade. A lot of central government ministries as well as some state governments completely on the eOffice platform. So when the system is behaving little erratic, just now that I have clicked on that, right, it has not moved. What you need to do is that simply log out and then log in and then you continue your work instead of doing some kind of a research on it. Right, and then have a faith and then trust on this platform. Right, this is a time tested for more than a decade across Government of India ministries and state governments. And then please give this same trust to your staff too. And then you have seen that to a receipt, how to attach a file. Similarly, your DRM has received one letter and then he asked some senior DPO sir that along with this letter, last week we received one more letter, you attach that and then send it to me. That means to a receipt you received, you can attach one file and then send it. Or to a receipt, you can attach one more receipt and then you send it, right? These are the two buttons for that. To this receipt, attach a file, or to this receipt, attach another receipt.
Again, same problem. Same.
So this is how that all these features you have seen that, right? Attach receipt to a receipt or attach a file to this receipt or if any draft has been put up by the sender, we will see that how the sender can set put up a draft to you, right? At that time, you will be able to know. But if any draft has come along with this receipt, by clicking on this, you will see that any receipt, any draft is attached to this, all those things you will be able to see. And we also have seen that how to close the file. Edit, we have seen that any metadata is wrong, you can edit it. Movements, we have seen that since the creation of this receipt, right? So from where to where it has moved. And then the details button, if you click on that, you will know that more than the movements, right? The movements will only tell you that this document has moved from A to B, B to C, C to D, but you will not know many more details about that. By clicking on this details tab, you will have a more details on that. If any files was attached to it, when it was attached, when it was detached, all such kind of information will be known by clicking on this details. And then the dispatch is something that, right, you want to dispatch it other than out of the eOffice platform. Within the eOffice platform, you just select the send or send back. We want to send this document to somebody outside the eOffice environment. Then you select this dispatch section and then you can send it by post or by hand or by mail or some kind of a thing. Copy, we have seen that. Put in a file, you create a new file or you put in an existing file. Either one you do it. And then send back to the original sender and then send to somebody else. So these are the things which are associated with the files that you see in the inbox, right? Whatever letter has come to you in your inbox, these are the actions that you do. Any doubts up to this?
Sir, one doubt, sir. In putting yes. file, you had shown how to put it in a new file. When you want to put it in this file, one example you can show, sir. How to
I have just shown that only, no? New file mein kaise dalte?
New file you are shown, sir. How to put
yes.
it in a new file?
Existing file, huh?
How to put
existing,
it in a
existing file also is same thing. You put in a file. You see that these are the files available. You select a file. And then you attach. Gone. See, earlier two receipts are there. One receipt gone into that file. Shall we show you one more also? Now you see that in my inbox, there is one letter available. Okay? I am clicking on this letter. And then I click on this put in a file. I have selected this E9 file. You remember, I will show you that in E9 file, the same letter is there or not. I will show you. Select that file. Simply put attach. You see that earlier one receipt was there in my inbox. Now it is no more there. It has gone into the file.
Okay.
You see that whether that is available in the file also or not, you will see that. You go to the file. You click on this completed. You select this E9 file. You click on that. This letter just now I have sent, that is available here. Okay?
Okay.
So any doubts up to now?
Yeah.
Yes, please.
How to detach a letter from the existing, from the file which I have just attached, but I don't want to keep it there, detach it. Is there a possibility?
Yeah. You can attach, you can detach also. That is not an issue. I will just to show you that here this browser is malfunctioning, but there is no issue. I will show you that. Fresh letter. Browser? Okay. I am selecting some random letter. And then here you are having one more facility available called the add to address book. For example, you are receiving the letters bar bar ek aadmi se aa rahe aapke paas. Ek bar wo details enter karne ke baad you click on this add to address book. Now that next time just you key in few letters, his entire details will come. Right? Automatically it will get filled. You please use that. Then select that. eOffice demo. Generate. Now I received one letter. I have diarized it. That's available in my inbox.
created, click on that. You see that now I am attaching one file to this receipt. Just now I created, I received a letter. I have scanned it, kept it in my desktop, and then gone to this browser and diaries. I entered the details, and then now along with this, I am attaching one file to this receipt. When I am attaching one file, I am sending along with one letter, I need to give a remarks. Right? Aapke paas ek letter aa gaya. A letter ke saath you are sending entire file to someone, right? Why you are attaching the file? Whenever you are attaching a file, or whenever you are detaching a file, or you are, again, whenever you are doing this attaching, detaching business, you need to give a remarks. Now I am just entering that DRM's instructions. You see that I am attaching this E16 file to this receipt. I am clicking on that. Special characters are not allowed. So now this letter has been attached with one file. You see that on the right hand side panel? You are having that one file got attached. Okay, are you able to see it? Somebody has asked me this doubt. You have attached one file here. To this receipt you have attached this file. And then at the end of that you are having one crossbar. This one. Red cross button is there. I am moving my mouse over there. Right? I have attached a file. By clicking on this, that file will get detached. I am clicking on this. I am detaching the file now. I have attached the file. Now I am detaching the file. I click on this. Again it asks that remarks. Why you are detaching the file? I am writing that work done. You see that no files has been attached to it anymore. You see that if you click on this details, it is telling that E16 file has been attached and then detached. Remarks furnished is that work done. Attached remarks are the DRM's instructions. Detached remarks are that work done. Attached is done at 11:43 hours. Detached is done at 11:44 hours. Everything can be traced excellently, right? Aisa nahi hai that hum ek file bhej diya bhai wo file gayab ho gaya. Aisa nahi hota hai. When you send the file, where it has gone, how it has gone, when it has gone, everything will get traced and then recorded. Any other doubts up to now?
Sir?
Yes, please.
If the original letter is still pending, how to send a reminder?
Reminders and all, you can set it over here. So you see that initially itself, I will show you on some other browser. Just 1 minute. Inbox, nothing is there. Just. I will just show you that how to set the reminders. You see here, somebody
yes,
asked me that. You see here, I am sending this receipt. One receipt is generated and then I am sending to Mr. Ashpal Singh Tomar. I am setting a due date. Right? So, a letter ke liye, I am expecting the reply within that. Right? So, I am expecting the reply. I am sending it on 14th. I am expecting the reply by 16th. I am setting that. Set due date. Right? You will get a warning. Right? And then alert. Both ends. And then action. What action that you are expecting, right? What kind of letter it is? Please discuss. Right? And then you can also set the priorities. You take that most immediate. The priority I have set it as most immediate. And then I have asked him that to give a reply by 16:05. Action I am asking him that you discuss with me. Okay? You discuss, you do the work, and it is most important. These three things I have said to this document. But these are optional actions. It is not a mandatory, right? Not with every letter. And then there is one remarks column is there. You want to add any remarks, you please add the remarks. Okay?
Okay, sir.
And then send. And then send. You see that this is a letter that has been sent just now, right? So the letter has come to him. You see here the letter. I request you, all of you, that please observe these important things, because you have set the due dates, you have set the priority, how they get reflected, right? I have sent a letter to someone, this person, I have said that it is most important, right, urgent like that. You see here, in his inbox this letter has come, it is having one red square box. What is the meaning of that also? At the bottom there are the legends are available, right? When the red is something, you see it, immediately it is known to you, it is most immediate, right? And then you see one more item is there, that is a due on, right? The due date also you have set, that is also available here. I am expecting him that you complete this by 16:05, okay? And then you click on this remarks. If you have furnished any remarks, it will come here. If you have not given any remarks, it will not come over there. Okay? So this is how that you will be able to set the alerts, priorities, due date to the senders. Any other doubts?
Yeah, one question. One letter is attached and enclosed, means attached to a file.
Yes.
And it was saved. Now that is known that it is not a right letter is attached to a right file, then how to remove that letter from a file?
When he sent it into a file, it cannot be removed. When you have put something in a file, it cannot be removed, it cannot be deleted. If you attach some letter to a file, that can be removed, but you have kept it, you have pushed into the file, and it cannot be removed. Here two things are there. You can attach a receipt to a file is different. Putting a receipt in the file is different. When you put the receipt in the file, you cannot detach it.
Okay. Thank you.
Any other doubts, please? Anyone? Nanded? Hyderabad? Trichy Division?
Nothing, sir.
Yeah. Any doubts, please?
No, sir.
Yeah. No doubts.
Nothing, sir, from Nanded. Thank you.
Okay. That's great. Any other doubts, please? Ravi? Western Railway. Western. Okay. Shall we proceed? We have seen this browse and diarize. We have seen inbox. And then the next tag available is that email diarization. The email diarization has not been activated for the Indian Railway module, so you need not do anything with it, right? In future course, it may get activated, so that whenever you receive a inward email, that email will get automatically diarized and then it can be converted onto the eOffice platform. Yes, please.
Sir, if you have put a wrong letter in a one file, okay, can it be transferred to some other file in correct file? The letter?
No, once you go into the file, it cannot be detached. But the same receipt will be available in your sent box. When you keep it in the file, right? Okay. Once the file is generated, then no.
Can be done. Adjust coach.
In, you can write it in a note that of that file that so and so letter is by mistake attached. Simple. You need not do much about it. See, you have you are having a file A and then some receipt by mistake you have kept it in that file A. Right? So, now that it cannot be removed or deleted from it. But you can give a noting side, you can write that so-and-so pages to so-and-so pages has been kept by mistake in this file. Simple. And then the original document will be available with you, right? It is a, there in your scanned copies, no? You can now keep it into the right file. There is no problem in that. And then every time you perform that actions, the computer, the eOffice platform will ask you that it is not that just you click it will go. It will ask you that so-and-so document is going into so-and-so file. Is it okay for you? Then also you are clicking it okay. Then no, there is nothing more can be done. Is it okay? Secunderabad division.
Okay, sir.
Yeah. So any other... This email diarization is not there in our railway environment and hence need not be worried about it. So in future course it may get activated, right? But as of now it's not there. And then you have seen this created. Whenever you scan something and then you choose the option, right? Only generate, right? You have chosen only the option generate, right? So, whatever the documents that you have generated, all those things will appear in this created list. Okay? So, this is where that this created list will be there. And then there is one more tab that is called the sent. Whatever the documents that you have dispatched, all those things will be available in your sent folder. From the sent folder, again, you can select that document and then you can send it further to the people. That is no issue in that. And then there is one more tab available called the closed. If any receipts you have closed, all those things can be traced over here. And then acknowledgements, right? If any acknowledgements that you have generated, all those acknowledgements will be available here. And then from here you can send it, right? Already sent acknowledgements are there. You see that morning we have sent one acknowledgement. Morning, we have sent one acknowledgement, right? Whatever acknowledgements you have sent will be available in this sent folder. Whatever you have created initially will be available in the created folder, right? And then the recycle bin is ineffective in the eOffice platform because nothing you can delete it on the eOffice platform. Hence, you can ignore it. Similarly, initiated actions also not customized to the railway environment. It is used in some other ministries, not in the Ministry of Railways. Hence, this recycle bin and then initiated actions also can be ignored at your end. So, with this, we have covered all the items pertaining to this receipts section. If people have any doubts, then I will be able to explain to you. Few items are left over that I will tell you. I will complete that, then we will go to the discussion forum. And then we will come to the files. You have seen earlier here, sent back. You also have seen the action sent. You also have seen the thing called the put in a file. You have not seen view, right? If you, this is a kind of a sorting, right? So, this heads are appearing when I clicked on this inbox, right? When you clicked on this inbox, these things are appearing. I will try to take one more account and then see that if any inbox letters are there so that I will be able to explain to you. So this is my inbox. On the inbox, you are having a different heads. Send back is there. Send is there. Put in a file is there. And then there is one more tab available, view. This is a kind of a sorting of the documents that are available in your inbox, right? Just you click on this unread. Only the unread documents are visible to you. Or read documents will be visible to you. Or if any VIP references are there, that also will be visible to you. This is a kind of a sorting mechanism. Or you just click on all the documents that is available in your inbox will be displayed over here. That is the purpose of this view. And then there is one more functionality available called the move to folders, manage folders, create a new folder. Right? It is just like that. For example, your inbox, you can organize it in such a way that a senior DPO is there. He is receiving the letters frequently from DRM and then other branch officers. He can create the folders, so DRM, ADRM, senior DST, like that, so that he will be able to organize all the letters according to that. We will see one example here. That is a you just click on this my folders. You hear that no folder is available right now to you, and then you create a new folder. Right? To create a new folder, the folder must have at least one receipt. So I selected this receipt, and then I go to this move to, and then create a new folder. I create a new folder that is GM O&M. That is my folder name. And then create in, right, receipts inbox, and then save. Special characters are not allowed. In place of and, you can use the small n wherever it comes. Let us see that. You see that earlier there was a receipt available in this inbox. Now it is no more there. You see that where that has gone. Right? So, you see here, I have created one folder within my inbox. GM O&M SCSR RailTel. So, when I click on that, within that folder, this receipt is available. That means this is a way you organize all your inboxes, right? If your inbox, you might be getting 100 letters. So all those things, you can organize it from the office wise using this move to feature, move to the create a new folder. And then you create that my folders. If you create in your inbox, whatever folders are there, that will get displayed over here. Manage folders. If you go to the manage folders, you can edit the folder name, or you can delete that folder also. You can create one more folder. Okay. When you created that, so before deleting the folder, it is asking that first you remove that letter, then only you can delete the folder. It will not allow you just to delete it. So, and then you select this letter, and then you select the move to, right? Move to my inbox. See that from this folder, it has gone into my inbox. I will just check it again. See, now it is available in my inbox. And then I want to delete this folder. I can delete it. That. Go to this. And then manage folders. This folder, if I want to delete it, just I click on that. Are you sure you want to delete the folder? Okay. Now that folder has gone. Earlier you see here, that now no more available there. Right. So now nothing is available in this folder. Should go. Log on. Just, that's not there here. Go to here. Manage folders. No folder is visible here. See, when you have deleted that folder, now that folder is no more available, right? Like that, using this move to feature, you can create the folders, you can manage the folders, etc. So, remaining things we have seen it, right? So, with this receipts portion has been completed. Many doubts are there on this receipts portion, we will have it. After that, we will have some 10 minutes break, and then we will join over here, again back. So, can you please, all you people, I encourage to ask your doubts pertaining to this receipt section. So far what we have discussed, if any doubts are there, we will have, I'm here to clarify you. Hyderabad division, Nanded division and all, some people are doing a wonderful job. I think they have kept one monitor also in front of them simultaneously.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
That is a wonderful thing. That's how the interactive session becomes extremely meaningful. So I request that in the subsequent sessions, people may please keep laptops or the desktops, etc. So that whatever you hear it through the TP, at least that you can just browse and then you can create a document, something you can practice it, so that you will have a complete hands-on training during this course itself.
Sir, one thing.
Yes, please.
Sir, can the emails be directly brought into the platform, sir? Whatever.
No, that is not there. That is, for that only this email diarization one feature is there, but that
fine,
is
sir.
Not yet activated on this platform. In future,
fine,
it may get activated, then it will be informed to all the people in that.
Right, gov.in or Gmail or
that
Yahoo
is not
mail,
integrated. Any... That is not. That actually, they want to do it. I think still under
fine.
Development, that module.
Fine, sir. Thank you.
Any other doubts, please? Any doubts regarding that what we have discussed till now?
Sir, वो eOffice का ये जो software है अपना
buildup हो गया कल शुभारंभ है.
So can we take a break for 15 minutes and then join back? Is it okay to all of you?
Okay, sir.
So now the time is 12:05. We will join at 12:20. Please be available, otherwise a lot of other people will be waiting and then it will cause a waste of time for others. Please be available at 12:20. Thank you. Yeah.
Okay, sir.
I request all of you that please keep the equipment on only, otherwise off karne ka, again on karne ka dikkat hota hai. Right? You can leave it and then you please join it after 20 minutes. Okay? 15 minutes. Please keep your equipment on only.
The recording off.